that's it.
You guys clean up well. Welcome, everybody, to Samantha and Eric's wedding. Samantha and Eric, this day is finally here. And obviously, this is a monumental day for the two of you, one you've been looking forward to for a while. But you know what? This is a big day for all of us. And that's just not just because we're all honored to be able to share this day with the two of you. You see, Sammy and Eric, for the rest of us, for the longest time, our 2021 calendars were blank, except for one day, July 3rd, 2021, the day of Sammy and Eric's wedding. This wedding has been a placeholder of sorts for all of us, the date by which we all hoped this darn pandemic would be in our rearview mirror so that we could do all the things that we used to take for granted, like attend a joyous celebration with all our family and friends. And thankfully, that's the case. So you see, Sammy and Eric, we're all going to remember this day, not just because it's your wedding, not just because we're happy for you and honored to be your guests, but to all of us, this day means we can start celebrating again. And I think that's going to happen in a little while. And we are all happy and honored to be here to share this day with the two of you. Today, we witnessed the union of an East Coast family and a Western family. So naturally, we have people from all over the country. People have traveled a lot of miles to be here today. I'll bet you that you folks have collectively traveled nearly 100,000 miles to be here today. Sammy and Eric, if that's not a testament to how much you mean to everyone here, I'm not sure what is. And to all of you, Eric and Samantha wanted me to let you know how thrilled and flattered and humbled they are to have you here to share this momentous day with them. We have people here who have provided love and support and friendship to Sammy and Eric throughout their lives. Friends of all stations, from all stations in their life, childhood friends, high school friends from West High and St. Joe's, Red Raiders from Colgate, Nittany Lions from Penn State, friends from work, and classmates from medical school, and of course, family. I have known the Saperstein's for years, and I've gotten to know the Frascas recently. And I have to say, there's a common thread that runs deep in both of these groups, the importance of family. And that is borne out by the number of family members who've traveled from far and wide to be here today. We welcome you all. But there are a few special shout-outs. Eric's brother Kyle is here with his wife Lauren and their baby Brooke, who is the cutest human here. They are here all the way from Germany. And of course, Sammy's sister Libby and Eric's sister Kara, both of whom we'll be hearing from in a little while. Sammy and Eric are lucky enough to have seven of their eight grandparents here in town. Bill and Bernadette from New Jersey, Horst, who is watching virtually, and Francoise from Florida, Lee and Cynthia from Magna, and Sandra from San Diego. And of course, a special remembrance today for Sammy's Papa Hirsch, a terrific guy who's here in spirit. And of course, the parents of the bride and the groom, Mom and Dad Saperstein and Mom and Dad Fresca. Samantha and Eric wanted to express how grateful and thankful they are for all that you have done and all that you mean to them. And while they are thankful for many things, each noted a unique and special trait they had been given by each of you. Dave, Sammy thanks you for instilling in her a love of nature, which is probably why we are here today. And Steph, Sammy credits you, and I'm quoting here, for her immature sense of humor. Bill and Aline are here from the great state of New Jersey. Bill, Eric credits you with his easygoing nature, and of course, for passing on his rabid New York Giants fan skills, which, as everyone will see, is a recurring theme here this evening. Aline, Eric says he gets his meticulousness from you, and he was very proud to brag to me about his apparently famous laundry folding skills. So everyone, let's join Sammy and Eric in giving thanks and a special shout out to their parents, Dave, Steph, Aline, and Bill, for everything they have done to make today possible. So, as you may know, I've had the pleasure and privilege of knowing Sammy and her family since she was a toddler. And I have to share my most vivid Samantha Saperstein memory. The date was November 15th, 2004. So you were nine. I chaperoned Sammy and her older sister Libby and Libby's friend, my daughter Hannah, to the Avril Lavigne concert at the Delta Center. Hannah and Libby were enjoying themselves, dancing and singing, like you would expect from 11-year-olds. But above the din of the crowd, I could hear this distinctive high-pitched voice singing all of the words to all of the songs at a volume well above everybody else in the crowd. I looked over, and there was Sammy, standing, tiptoed on her seat, her arms spread to the sky, her eyes closed, screaming at the top of her lungs the words to Skater Boy. It was an indelibly cute moment that I will never forget. Now, I've only known Eric for a little over a year, but I've discovered we are kindred spirits of a sort. We both love to golf, and I have to tell everybody, the last time Eric was in town, he eagled the first hole. True story. And of course, we are both passionate New York sports fans. Although, Eric, I'm more than a little envious that you were lucky enough to have been born into a family that cheers for the winning New York sports teams. One of the best things about officiating a wedding like this is it gives me a better opportunity to get to know Samantha and Eric a little better. So we sat down for lunch a while back and we talked about how they met. Turns out they met the way a lot of young people meet these days, on a dating app. So I followed the meeting up with some personal questions via email that I asked them to respond to. And I asked them what their initial impressions were about each other. And Sammy's response was just so perfect that I'm just going to read it to you. So she said she was lukewarm about Eric at the start. But then, on maybe our fourth or fifth date, he took me to a Mexican restaurant in DC that had salsa nights on Wednesday. Little did I know, Eric's mom made him take ballroom dancing class in college, which included other types of dance, like salsa. So, after a couple of margaritas, we danced, and this very white hockey-playing boy from New Jersey taught me how to salsa and totally outdanced me all night. So I was hooked. Now, Eric's response about his initial impression of Samantha was, shall we say, a little bit more superficial than that. He said they met online, and he was really nervous to meet Samantha in person. But when he did, he was relieved about two things. First, that Sammy was just as cute in person as she was in her photo. Second, he was relieved to find out he hadn't been catfished. And if you don't know what that means, find a younger person in the crowd after the ceremony and they will explain it to you. So these two met in the fall of 2018, but Eric is apparently a pretty private person and he never told his family that they had met or were dating. But his family suspected something was up because they stalked his Venmo account and could see all of the transfers between the two of them. Time went on, but still, Eric said nothing. Finally, one day, Eric's sister Kara was out with Eric and some of his friends. And when Eric excused himself to take a powder, she looked at her friends and said, "Okay, who is Samantha Saperstein?" And finally, the cat was out of the bag. So they have spent the better part of the last 2 years together. During that short time, they've lived in Washington, D.C. and Cincinnati. They've crisscrossed the country between New Jersey and Utah. You can only imagine how busy these two have been with Sammy in med school, planning a wedding, and traveling all around the country, and with Eric working, and of course, playing in his evening men's hockey league teams. Yet through it all, they remain unfazed. They manage to spend lots of time together doing the things they like to do. They like to go out to eat, go to movies, go bowling, enjoy nature, and of course, watching New York Giants football games. I asked them what they each liked and respected about the other, and they each had a very long list of flattering things to say, which is a really good sign. Sammy likes that Eric is silly, intelligent, energetic, kind, generous and thoughtful, selfless and supportive. She says Eric has a certain gentle charm that helps him get along with everybody and make anyone smile in any situation. And she added, which is the reason why he's the one who deals with customer service reps. Eric said he loves that Sammy is easy to talk to, that she's funny and makes him laugh. He calls her a genuine, kind, and compassionate person who is super positive and almost always upbeat. And he really appreciates how easygoing she is, especially since that easygoing nature lets him watch sports all the time. Of course, I also asked them something about the other that kind of drives them crazy. And I could tell from the responses that was hard too, which is also a really good sign. The best Sammy could come up with was Eric's inability to be serious. Except, however, when he's watching New York Giants games, when he apparently becomes very serious. Eric mentioned Sammy having medical student syndrome, which is a condition where medical students perceive themselves to be experiencing the symptoms of a disease that they happen to be studying. So every week, since Sammy started med school, she has been convinced she has one affliction or the other. And here I will quote Eric's email, in which he mentioned an example of this phenomenon. He said, "As I am writing this, Samantha went to bed early with a headache. She has requested me to go into the bedroom to check on her, periodically, to make sure that she doesn't suffer a brain bleed." And then he says, in all caps, followed by 7 exclamation points, "How in the world would I be able to diagnose a brain bleed?" You guys have an excellent sense of humor. I asked them what they hoped they'd be doing on their 25th anniversary. Now keep in mind, they sent me responses separately and didn't know what the other person had said. Sammy said, "Hopefully we'll be off somewhere having fun and laughing and not watching ESPN. Though I'll probably spend that night sitting in the stands watching his 11 p.m. men's hockey league game." Eric, again, responding separately, said, "In the perfect world, they'd be on a nice vacation on some island, relaxing, enjoying frozen drinks with the little umbrellas in them." But he says, "Samantha knows what she's signing up for. I can almost guarantee that on Tuesday, July 3rd, 2046, there will be an 11 p.m. adult hockey league game calling my name."
That's right.
So after only a couple of years, at least one thing is clear. You two know each other remarkably well. I asked them what it means to be married to the other, and Sammy said, "By being with Eric, I am the best, brightest version of myself." Which, when you think about it, is about the highest praise a person could give another person. Eric commented on how much fun they have together, how special Sammy is to him, that he can't believe he gets to spend the rest of his life with her. Who knows what forces brought together the two of you, a guy from Jersey and a gal from Utah, but whatever it is, this much is clear. You two are lucky to have found one another and are lucky to be able to spend the rest of your lives together. So Sammy and Eric, as you embark on your journey together, and I speak on behalf of everyone here, we hope you continue to experience life together wherever your paths may take you. We hope you get to travel all over the globe and live in as many places as you can. We hope you continue to love each other and each other's company and continue to do the things that you both enjoy. We can only hope that 15 years from now, Dr. Saperstein will be able to juggle her busy work schedule to get to the doubleheader hockey games. The first one with Coach Frasca's coaching the Pee Wee game, and then the 11 o'clock Old Man's League game featuring Eric in the net.
That's the dream.
And Eric, we wish you many ASCA Cups in your future to go along with championship hockey teams, a low-digit golf handicap, and many Giants victories. And Sammy, we wish you mountains and mountains of patience. And before we proceed with the vows, Libby and Kara have some words for us.
Okay, I will be reading a poem from The Hobbit. "Roads go ever on and on, over rock and under tree, by caves where never sun has shone, by streams that never find the sea, over snow by winter sown, and through the merry flowers of June, over grass and over stone, and under mountains in the moon. Roads go ever, ever on, under cloud and under star, yet feet that wandering have gone, turn at last to home afar. Eyes that fire and sword have seen, and horror in the halls of stone, look at last on meadows green, and trees and hills they long have known."
Hi. Hi, everyone. I will be doing a reading from 1 Corinthians. It's a classic. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres.
Samantha and Eric, may you make wise decisions with the time that is given to you. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows. May you love each other with all the madness in your souls, and may you have a long, happy, and healthy life together. Are you now ready to accept the vows of marriage?
Yeah, I think so. Should I say something first or after?
Oh, did you want to say something?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Well, first of all, thank you everyone for coming. So last night, Samantha, I'm just going to step out here so y'all can see me. Last night, after all of the event and everyone gathering, Samantha wrote me a letter. For the past 2 weeks, we've been talking about whether or not we wanted to say something about each other. Samantha is a much more open person and speaks a lot about her feelings. That's not my style. So she wrote this letter, and I read it, and it was beautiful. So I texted her this morning, and I said, like, let's do it. I'm in. I'll talk about you. You can read the letter to everyone, but I forgot the letter, so that is totally on me. We weren't going to do it, but she is a far greater person than I am, so she's still going to let me say what I wanted to. Before I do it, for anyone who doesn't know, my mom's dad is in the hospital, so he couldn't be here, but he's on FaceTime. So I want everyone to say hi, Opa. Can we say hi? All right. How about that, Opa? Pretty cool, right? I'm going to turn it around so I can say hi. How you doing? You feeling good? All right. I'm going to go say some words, but I love you, all right? All right. Okay. Now for the speech. I'm going to take it out here. So the first thing I wanted to do before we actually got started is I was going to actually ask everyone here if y'all could just stand up for me for a second. All right. All right. I really appreciate that. All right. Y'all can take a seat now. So I've always wanted to do that with a large crowd, and that was a lot of fun. So thank you. Thank you. Okay. So, you know, I'm sure you've now figured this out. I really enjoy the sound of my own voice. But when it comes to expressing my feelings, I usually am a man of pretty few words. So for all the things that Samantha and I do have in common, that is absolutely not one of them. So just one quick story here about the two of us. But one thing that we do fairly often is, you know, when we go to bed, we'll be laying there, and Samantha will say to me, you know, tell me three things that you're grateful for. And all you need to know is just about every time she asks me this, I can tell when it's coming, I totally freeze up. It is essentially like if you were to ask a first grader when you picked them up from school what you learned today, and they just totally blank out, that's what I do. So being the excellent and great partner that Samantha is, she goes first. So typically her three things that she is grateful for are along the lines of, you know, just she is such an expressive person and great with words, and it's typically along the lines of, I'm so grateful for you, you're beautiful, your family, you're amazing, and it's just like everything she says is perfect. And meanwhile, as she's saying this, I'm listening, but I'm also freaking out in my own head. I am just trying to plan ahead. What am I going to say that can even remotely come near what she does? So it'll be my turn to go. I'm thinking in my head. I'm feeling really good about all these choices. So my first one, it'll be something along the lines of, you know, I'm really grateful for ShopRite apple juice because that stuff is just so good. I love it so much. And then I'll say, oh yeah, the dinner tonight we ate was awesome. That was great. Really grateful for that. But then I finish strong and I'll say, I'm just really grateful, you know, to be with you and to be able to live life with you because you're just such an amazing person. So my gift for Samantha today is I have put a little bit more effort in, and I have wrote down three things that I am extremely grateful for. So the first thing is I am grateful for your just total devotion to service and giving back to the community and just always wanting to give to others. Many times make me feel pretty bad about myself, but you're constantly giving back to others, and just every day I spend with you, it makes me the best version of myself. The second thing that I'm grateful for is Samantha's sense of humor and also her ability to appreciate my sense of humor. She will always cheer me up. She always just has a great time in any sort of circumstance we're in. It doesn't matter if I'm freaking out during a Giants game, there's just some super stressful times going on with work or we're planning a wedding. She's just always there to keep me grounded and just make me realize what's important in life. And lastly, I'm gonna reuse one, but I am just so grateful for you and to just have you and to be here today and to be able to spend the rest of my life with you is probably the coolest thing ever. And I love the New York Giants, and if they could win another Super Bowl this year, I'd be like thrilled, but nothing would ever compare to spending the rest of my days with you. So that's my speech. Hers was also much nicer than that, but luckily for me, you don't have to hear it. So thank you.
You want to say anything? You want to say anything? No?
I'll just say that my letter was pretty good.
It was.
And it had a really great joke at the end. Just imagine. Thank you.
We'll fetch it before the reception. We'll read it in there.
Let's do it. All right. Are you each ready to accept the vows of marriage?
Yes.
Yes, we are.
All righty. Kyle, ring.
Doesn't get old.
All right, Eric, if you would place the ring on Samantha's finger. Eric Frasca, do you take Samantha Saperstein to be your wife, to be her husband, friend, and companion, to love, comfort, honor, and respect her, in good times and in bad, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Samantha, if you would place the ring on Eric's finger. Samantha Saperstein, do you take Eric Frasca to be your husband, to be his wife, friend, and companion, to love, comfort, honor, and respect him, in good times and in bad, for as long as you both shall live?
Absolutely.
Having made these vows in the presence of the families and friend here assembled, and by the authority vested in me by the people of the state of Utah, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
All right, here it goes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Eric Frasca and Samantha Saperstein. Yeah, man.
We'll be right back.
I wait here. Everybody's invited to the cocktail hour in the lodge over to your right.
Friends and family, welcome out to Samantha and Eric's wedding celebration. We are excited to have you all here today. My name is Cooper Brown. I will be your DJ and MC for the evening. We have a packed house today, and I am super excited. Now, here we have people from all over the country, possibly even the world. Who is from the East Coast? Make some noise. Oh, yes. Perfect. And what about the West Coast? West Coast. Yes. And what about Central United States? Where are you at? Everybody else? Perfect. Perfect. How to make sure we've got everybody. No one got left out. So right now, we are going to introduce our wedding party. This is the moment where we bring all the energy and love we possibly can into the room. So you are welcome to scream, shout, and get as loud as you possibly can as we introduce our wedding party. Please turn your attention towards the main staircase in the back and put your hands together for Libby and Kyle. Libby and Kyle, bring it. Yeah, yeah. Libby and Kyle, bring it. Bring it, put your hands together for Karen John. Here we go, here we go. And now make some noise for Lauren and Tyler. Jacket's coming off. Jacket's coming off. Oh. And now show some love for Annie and Peter. Be the music. Clap, clap, clap. Sydney and Vinny. Go, 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 go. Yeah. Lucy and David. Go, go, go. Uptown, funk you up. Dance, jump on it. If you say
don't own it. I do some stuff.
And next, let's give a loud welcome to Emily and Michael. Go, 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 go. And next, let's get loud for Ian, Joe, and AJ. Hey, hey, hey. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand. Please stand. And join me in welcoming our guests of honor, Samantha and Eric. Put your hands together, clap, 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 clap.
Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Hey, 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 oh.
Stop, wait a minute. Fill my cup, put some liquor in it. Take a sip, sign the check.
May be seated. All right, how was that? Woo! That was fantastic. Oh, what a day. What a day. Welcome everybody, friends, family, whoever snuck in. This is great. Just an exciting day, and we're very happy all of you are here. So I'm gonna pass the mic to Steph first, and then she's gonna pass it back to me, and we'll get going. All right.
I will not be denied. Okay, 2 hours ago, 5 became 6. I'm gonna cry just for a sec, Sam, I promise. 5 became 6, welcome to the era of the Saperstein Stockstill Frascas. Or as I like to call it, hashtag Sapstillaska. It took me a while to come up with that. For 21 years, there were the four of us. And then in 2014, 4 became 5, and Libby married Tyler Stockstill. And Tyler was so wonderful, and he became such a smooth part of our family. It felt like he had been one of us forever. And frankly, I felt a little bit bad for Sam, because I wasn't sure how she was gonna follow up with Tyler. And I had visions of Sam and I being Big Edie and Little Edie down in Gray Gardens of Sugar House. She didn't like that. And then I thought, okay, she can be the rooster to my Mr. Sedaris, and we would spend our years together. Don't ask me where I thought Dave was, probably in the kitchen somewhere, because he never played a part of these visions that I had at any point. But she's here. In any event, Sammy met Eric. It took her a year to tell me about him. Thanks, Libby, because Libby and Tyler met him a lot earlier before we did, and somehow kept that secret, which I will never forgive them for. But she fell in love with this kid from Hackensack. I thought, Hackensack, where the hell is that? But we found, is that a real place? Is that like Brigadoon or something? But she fell in love with Eric. We fell in love with Bill and Aline and with Hackensack when we were all there and got to meet a number of you, and we had the best times of our life, and now you are here being part of our lives in Utah, and we hope you are having a great change. And I'm just thrilled that Samantha found somebody who would take her on. This is the girl. This is the girl we called Sumanji after the movie Jumanji, because she left chaos wherever she went. But she found him, and he's wonderful, and we love him. And I have made it very clear to Eric, very clear, that there I have a no return policy. So because of my policy and being the lawyer I am, I need to make some very things clear so that he knows what he's buying, in full disclosure. And so here are a couple of things, Eric. First of all, Sammy may spend months at a time speaking in an English accent, because that has happened in the past and we don't know when it will come back. Also, Sandy has a tendency to boo you if she doesn't like what you do. So if you ask her to do something or you do something, she will give you a resounding boo before she turns around and walks away to do it. Also, Eric, Sammy does not eat condiments of any sort. The dry sandwich, the dry salad, not even salad dressing. So be prepared for a lifetime of dry salad. And then finally, never, and I mean never, run out of Silver Patron, because you need to have Silver Patron tequila, for those of you who don't know, always. It will be a problem if you don't have it in the house. And finally, to end, so because we're all anxious, Dave's anxious to get started, I have just two pieces of advice for you. The first advice is to never follow unsolicited advice. So forget everything I've said. And then the second piece of advice is, and I cannot mean this more, you're always going to need a bigger salad bowl. The first one you choose will never be big enough. So take care of her, take care of the baby. Welcome to the family. Welcome Bill and Aline and Francoise and Bernadette and Big Bill and even Aunt Betty. We love you all. Thank you for coming to Utah, and have a good time tonight.
So as usual, I have given Stephanie the first chance to speak, and I've been cut off. So you will hear from me later, but I just wanted to tell Sammy how much I love her. And Eric, welcome. And just the coming together of these families is going to be great. They say, give away your daughter at a wedding. It's not, I don't think you're giving anything away, you're getting. And that's the beauty of it. So have a great time tonight.
Because she's not property.
Well said. I like that. I like that. We've got three speeches by three very special and important people. Our first will be given by Sammy's older sister, who runs a nonprofit here in Salt Lake City and was just recognized by the U.S. Soccer Federation for her work in the community. Wow. She did not know I was going to say that. She made a career change and started teaching high school for the first time this upcoming school year. Let's welcome our maid of honor, Libby.
you for the introduction, Samantha. That will only fuel my speech a little bit more. So I feel honored, but also a lot of pressure being the first one to speak, because I've had the pleasure of getting to know Kyle, the best man, who is awesome and just hilarious. So you'll forget mine if it's bad, so just bear with me. So I think that for any bride, the two people who know you the best are your significant other and your older sister. So I feel obliged to tell you a little bit about what the real Sammy is like for those of you who don't know her. So many of you know Sammy as, I'll just paint this picture for you. We know Sam now as a star medical student, just breezed her way through med school, excellent grades, excellent, very studious, on top of everything. Now, let me paint you a different picture of 4-year-old Sam getting in trouble at the JCC preschool for teaching everybody new words, new 4-letter words. No teeth, no 2 front teeth, climbing trees, and as you know, my mother mentioned earlier, earned the nickname Sumanji because of the path of destruction she left in her wake. A little different picture than what you might know. For those of you who were at the rehearsal dinner, you may have heard Sam's friends talk about how cool Sam was as a teenager, how cool she is now. She was the Vampire Weekend girl. She knew everything on the verge of pop culture. She's really pretty. She's a cool girl. Again, let me paint another picture for you. The Sam that I know, 8 years old, dressed up in disco clothes, recreating scenes from Chicago. The scenes that you wouldn't expect an 8-year-old to recreate with Jade Larson in our basement, singing at the top of her lungs. Oh, and Mamma Mia, don't forget, our lifelong love of ABBA. Again, going back to what a lot of you know her as, is a server of her community, always service, putting her community first. She's helping the unsheltered right now. She's doing ESL tutoring. She traveled to Peru. That Sam. Another Sam that I know is 14-year-old Sammy, hood up, earbuds in, eyeliner to rival Cher, obsessively listening to Donnie Darko, in my car on the way to school, angry at me for making her late, angry at the world for not feeling and sharing in that angst that poured out of that tiny teenage little body. That's the Sam I knew. And while you all know Sam now, I know Sam now and in the past. And what I know to still be true is that whether she was 12 years old or 25, Sam would make sure that if I had a bad day after school, she'd bake for me. That Sam always made sure that everybody was fed. This entire wedding process, Sam has been worried about what everybody else is doing. What is Eric going to think? What can I do that will make Eric happy? What can I do to make my family happy? As we age, we change. We do change. We become different versions of ourselves. I've known a lot of versions of Sammy. But over time, we keep the best parts of ourselves. And the truest parts. And the truest parts of Sam are kind and loyal and worried about other people and worried about making the best impression that she can in the world. Now, getting back to what I said about how the people who know you best are your big sister and your significant other. Loving someone, whether they're your sibling or your spouse or partner or whoever, you have to learn to love them through their worst and their best, their weirdest, their kindest, their noodle dancing in public, the time they spoke in an accent for a year or made whale sounds for 2 years. But you must learn to love them through all of that. And lucky for you, Eric, that even at Sam's worst, she's still better than most people. And I say that having seen her worst. And you will see that as well. And so I think my job as the maid of honor and getting this speech today was not so much to talk to you all, but to talk to you, Eric, so it's all on the record. That you better love my Sammy through her worst and through her best, and you will, and you better know that no matter what you do, she's gonna love you back, no matter what version of you you become, no matter what version of you that she knows. And as her older sister, I want the best for her. I feel so lucky that I've had just the perfect marriage and the perfect spouse myself. And I worried about, despite what popular opinion might be.
At table seven.
The guy who's posing. So I worried about what version of my sister would be accepted by who her significant other would be. Because I know that no matter what version of Sammy that she is, she's lovable and she's keepable. Keepable. And I feel that just the little time that I've known you, that you will do that and you will love her through all of that. And I feel good about your journey going forward. And the reason that I picked the talk that I did today, not just because it was The Hobbit and Sam's obsessed with Lord of the Rings, as am I, it was a poem about coming home and going on a journey, going on adventures, and coming back home. And that's what Sammy is to me, and that's what she better damn well be to you. Sammy is home no matter where you are, no matter if it's a 4-month-long text conversation, if you haven't seen each other in a year, that's Sammy. So enjoy your time together. Make home wherever home may be. Accept each other through whatever versions of yourselves you can be, whether it's your best or your worst. I love you both. I'm so excited to have you in our family. And let's just raise our glasses in a big round of Mazel Tov.
Great job to Libby. That was incredible. Well done, Libby. Our next speech will be given by Eric's older brother, who currently lives in Germany. Eric selected him as his best man despite his older brother never letting Eric win in backyard pickup basketball. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please welcome our best man, Kyle.
So that sums it up right there. He actually took a bit from my speech in my introduction, but that's fine. We'll move on. First, can everyone give it up for Libby? That was a great speech. So I know she's saying I'm funny, whatever. That was awesome. So thank you. And thank you to Dave and Steph for everything. A bunch of the guys, we ended up showering at their house randomly the other day. They have completely opened their doors to all of us. So thank you both. Thank you to my parents for everything. It's been really great. So what I do want to do, though, is it's really important that I give a bunch of you some context on this speech. So the Frasca contingent will remember from my wedding 5 years ago that Eric was the best man at my wedding. And he gave what has been said to be the single greatest best man speech ever delivered. So since that day, I have known that this day would come where I needed to deliver this speech. So naturally, I started putting pen to paper yesterday. Now, I'm kidding. I did have ideas in my head, but I actually started writing stuff down yesterday. And you know, for those that don't remember, and for the Saperstein crew that was not there, the speech was very elaborate. It involved props, many props, a lot of jokes. We were getting up, we were moving around, and I'll just highlight a few of the things. And one of the things I thought about is, how do I top that? You know, how do I do that? And if I think about the props that were used, the problem is that Eric and I are the same person. The props apply to him. So the three props that he gave were, he was basically telling Lauren what to be prepared for in our marriage. And so what he did is he had three items that he brought to help Lauren be prepared to be with me. The first item was a can of Bush's baked beans. Because Eric and I are both creatures of habit, and when we like a food, we eat it every day. And at that time, I was eating Bush baked beans every day. I don't think I've had a can since, but I think, you know, when I thought about it, that's pretty much Eric and apple juice. ShopRite apple juice, it's exactly the same. Now the second item, which actually is exactly identical, was bubble wrap. So he brought bubble wrap because what I had done in the past, during a New York Giants game, I had gotten so angry that I kicked my foot down on the couch and I snapped the recliner in two. So the bubble wrap was brought so that Lauren could bubble wrap our house. Samantha, that will happen to you. You need to buy bubble wrap. I couldn't bring it from Germany. Now the third item was a set of earplugs. So I'm a guitarist, I play a lot of guitar, very loud. So they were meant to be so that Lauren could drown it out when I'm playing during the day or whenever. Eric is not really a musician. He plays the drums, or I make him play the drums so that we can jam. But what's similar is he loves hockey, probably the same amount that I love music. So while you wouldn't need earplugs, Samantha, you really need a nose plug, because hockey is the stinkiest sport around. And Eric, he really smells bad after hockey. So those were the three items, and I just realized that it was going to be repetitive doing something similar. I couldn't top it, right? So I decided on something a little bit simpler, right? So before, you know, I realized I've been talking about this speech that Eric gave, so I'm gonna first start with Sammy, and then we'll go back to Eric. So Sammy, I mean, we have not known you, obviously, as long as Eric, but one of the things that really amazes me with Sammy is how fast she integrated into our family. Like, from the moment you came back with Eric, it's like you had been with us for 20 years. It really was amazing. One of the things that we've done in Germany to make sure that we're staying in touch with, you know, Sam and Eric and, you know, my parents and everyone, is we do a lot of video calls. And we have our special things with everyone that we do. And it's really been great. We have, I think all of you have met my daughter, Brooke, over there. I think she was making the rounds. Really everyone wants to see her. So that's why we do these calls. But there she is. So one thing that Sammy is amazing at that I'm actually gonna need you to stand up for. All right, so whenever we, yo, come on, come. She knows, she already knows. So one thing that she is amazing at, that incredible with Brooke, is Brooke loves Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. And Brooke loves to dance to two Mickey Mouse Clubhouse songs. One of these songs is the hot dog dance. Now, no one I know does the hot dog dance better than Samantha. So Samantha, I'm gonna need you to show Brooke, because we've come all the way from Germany, and all these people, the goofy dance from the hot dog dance.
Hot dog!
Give it up for Sammy. You can sit down. I knew that was going to be fun with the dress. we talked to Sammy a lot, and Sammy and Eric, when we're over in Germany, talked about how you know, she's fully integrated into the family. The thing I'd highlight, we had the rehearsal dinner yesterday, and everyone said some really nice things. I think Kara said this, but, you know, one of the first things when I talked to Eric, when, you know, he first told me about you, you know, I asked, like, you know, what is she like? What, you know, tell me about her. And Kara said this the other day, but just so for those that weren't there, he said, she is the nicest human being I've ever met. Like, she is incredible. And it's true. She really is. So I, you know, you really are, Sammy. So that's my sappy part. So now we're going to jump back to Eric. And yeah. So Eric, so I knew I wanted Sammy to do the hot dog dance for this speech. But for Eric, it's a little more challenging. I've known Eric, you know, my entire life. And I feel like with these speeches, you know, what you want to share with this group is something that maybe only I have seen from, you know, growing up with Eric. But the problem is, what you see is what you get. He's incredibly transparent, and it's tough because, you know, like, he is who he is. The best example of this is, you know, a lot of us have our things that we do in private. One thing is, you know, sometimes we like to sing in private. Eric's a terrible singer. I'm sure many of you have heard him sing Frozen. Maybe not, but he will sing that to anyone. Would you like to sing that for anyone? So I'm gonna hand the mic over and we'll get a little bit of the silly side here that you all have seen.
Wow. You can all blame Kyle for this. Yeah, let's do it. I could go a cappella. You guys want a cappella? Yeah! All right.
Cold never bothered me anyway. The glow's white on the mountain tonight. Not a footprint
to be seen. A kingdom of isolation. And it looks like Sam's the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried.
Don't work the crowd.
Go let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Back anymore. Let it go. Let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway. Amazing. Incredible. So that kind of sums up the point that I wanted to hit with him. He is always game for anything. And growing up, he was always game for anything when we were doing stuff together. So Eric's 4 years younger than me. But an example of this is we used to love to play street hockey. So Eric, I mean, he's a goalie now through and through. But in his early days, I think one of the reasons he became a goalie is we had these huge goalie pads that no one wanted to wear, and Eric was always the guy that he was willing to put them on. So we would throw him in net with these oversized pads, and we probably played hockey like 300 to 365 days for a lot of years. Another funny one, so I mentioned that I play guitar. Eric played drums in second grade. So when I started playing guitar more and getting in a band, I wanted to jam more. So naturally, I told Eric, well, you're a drummer, so we're gonna jam. So I would bring him down into the basement. I mean, he likes playing drums, but not every day for 3 hours. And he was always game to come down and always would play drums with me while I would play guitar. And it just sums up, like, he is the best brother. I knew that was gonna be a tough one to get through. And he's the best brother, and Kara and I have always said it, He is the best Frasca. He really is. So, Sammy, you really hit the jackpot with him. He is incredible. He's the nicest, smartest. He's incredible. And super thoughtful and caring. I know most of you have seen that. So, he is the best. You're the best. So the last little thing I did want to pull out is I would love it if Brooke could join me over here, because she asked me to if she could contribute something to this speech. So I'm gonna see if she wants to say her part of the speech here. Okay. I knew this was a risk. I knew this was a slight possibility. Brooke, can you help me? No, it's okay. All right. So I'll cut off that bit. Ask me about what she was going to say later. Oh. Hey, can you repeat after me? Okay, great. Can you say I?
I.
Can't?
No.
Oh, it's okay. Say can't. Oh, can you repeat after me, please? No. Oh. Well, she was going to say, I can't wait for cousins. All right. And with that, I love you both so much. You're incredible. Have a great night. Love you so much. Have a great night, everybody.
Now, I've been told this gentleman is the most popular person in Salt Lake City. Everybody seems to know him, and he likes to cook up a storm. And when he does cook, he cooks for a large, large group of people, even if it's a small group. Now, we heard from him briefly earlier, but now is his real deal speech. Let's go ahead and welcome up David.
Oh my God, there's no way I can top those two. Those were great speeches. I really didn't plan on anything lengthy. I had a couple of things I wanted to do, obviously besides telling you guys how much I love you. I did want to share just how Kyle said that Samantha integrated in their family. I wanted to tell the story about the first time that I met Eric. And that was, I was in San Diego, visiting my parents. My father was starting to fail, and Stephanie planned a surprise trip to fly all the kids out, and we were staying in La Jolla, and I think it was, oh, I was sitting on the bed, and the American Express starts charging my phone. I'm like, I'm not paying for a second room. What the hell is going on here? And so I'm like, you know, I was in the hotel business for a while. I'm ready to rip the front desk, double charge in my thing. Turns out all the kids showed up. And here comes Eric. And honest to God, in the first minute, it was like he had been part of our family for 20 years. The two of them are remarkable. They're so thoughtful and caring and sensitive. They communicate incredibly well. And I'm just so happy for both of you. And just looking forward to all of our families being together and being a big family in the future. And just with Libby and Tyler and Eric and Sam, And I'm sorry I'm gonna do this because I have a million things I wanted to say, and I don't wanna be a Debbie Downer about it, but the whole experience with my father, which Eric and Tyler were both incredibly supportive and helpful, it made me realize that you wanna have son-in-laws like that. You wanna have people come into your family that are gonna be there with you at the end, that you're so happy to do and to have there. And that's how I feel about both of them and all of my children. And it's just been an incredible time. And Sammy has always been my little angel. And in terms of everything that everybody said about her is true, except for maybe what's, you know, Libby was on the board. No, I'm just kidding. But an example is we took a trip to the Tetons, and Sam was three years old, and we had Lee and Cynthia's truck. We'd borrowed that. It was the middle of the night, and I was falling asleep at the wheel, and everybody else was asleep. And then all of a sudden, here's this little three-year-old, Daddy, just tapped me on the shoulder. We stayed up the whole night. We watched meteors while we were driving. And it was like I never forgot that. And Sam's always kind of been that way for me and for so many people. And I'm just so happy. So, but I'm not done. There's more. Oh yeah. We got props. We got props. So one of the things that if everyone knows who Elizabeth Smart is, there was a time in Salt Lake when everybody was worried about leaving their doors unlocked. And for the longest time, Sam had this thing with her car where she always folded the back seat down so she always knew who was in the car. Hopefully nobody. And she carried a sword. And we call it the Sword of Sammy. So I thought that since Sam spent so much time concerned about everybody else and making sure that everybody was okay and always safe, that she had this sword. And now that she has Eric to do that, I'm going to present Eric with the Sword of Sammy. Even though it says the Sword of Gryffindor, it's the Sword of Sam. So anyway, I know all the younger people want to get rolling and dancing and drinking, and we just are so happy that everybody's here. Thank you, and have a fabulous time tonight. We love you all.